Live right now, our time nice. With an amazing guy. Look at his face. It's Paul Rudd.
What's How's it up? Going?
I'm good. How you feeling?
I'm good. I'm feeling all right. I haven't stretched.
I think you should before you start.
Probably, right?
It'll help a touch, a touch. Well, let's rewind back to how you got involved with our time, man.
Okay. Well, I was doing a play 6 years ago, and the character I was playing had a stutter, and I didn't know much about stuttering. Certainly at the kind of the level that this character stuttered. So I met Taro, who formed Our Time, and it was fairly new at that point. But I got to come to some of the meetings, I met some of the kids, and I was blown away by the kids and what he was creating here, because there was nothing like this. And it was something that I think most people don't think about. You know, to be a kid and not be and be insecure and sensitive about, one, speaking with anybody, any kid, any grown-up has trouble with that, and then to be afraid of being teased or bullied or people not wanting to talk to you because it takes sometimes a long time to get your sentences out, and it's very easy to close yourself off and to just be quiet and kind of live in your head. And this was a place where kids who suffer from this can get together and feel like a kid and feel comfortable. And these kids are amazing. And then the stuff that they can do, to see like the looks on their faces of what they can accomplish, speaking in front of hundreds of people on a stage, performing in plays, doing things that they never would have done before, and just the empowerment that they feel and the confidence they gain. It knocked me out.
I think it's an incredible event. It's really an honor to be a part of it. It's giving the kids confidence to really be able to speak, and I'm just so humbled to be a part of it. And it's really unfortunate that sometimes people have this in their life, and it's really amazing that we have people like Paul and people here that will, you know, put their heart and souls into something and a great cause like this.
But I had a stuttering problem as a kid myself. Yeah. And what I found out was that, you know, it has to do with a lot of smart kids that have a lot to say and they want to say it quickly, they want to be heard. And normally with siblings and bigger families, you know, you're just trying to get it in. You're trying to get those words in, right?
Yeah.
And so, like, sometimes you can take a breath, slow down, and do that weird actor thing where you stretch your mouth. So, like, you play basketball, you got to stretch your legs, you got to stretch your arms. You're going to talk, all that kind of stuff, right? So that's what orators do, and that's what actors do. And so, like, I learned how to really sort of slow down, stretch my mouth out before I talked. And I didn't lose it until I was, like, 12.
Really?
Yeah. I was like, yeah. Yeah.
Yo, that's incredible. Now you make your living
by
speaking.
Talking.
Yo, that is so cool.
Yeah. So, you know, it's I get it. Like, when I see some of these kids and I talk to them, I see myself, you know? And, you know, it's there's a long road for them to travel, but they'll get there for sure.